Tēnā koutou katoa. This month is a time to celebrate. It's 25 years since Aotearoa New Zealand ratified the Children's Rights Convention. It's a beautiful document. It speaks aspirationally of what all our children are entitled to. As we reflect on the last 25 years, we can acknowledge a sector that has been committed to putting children's rights and entitlements first. That said, as we survey how well our children are doing, there's pause for significant concern. As a brief snapshot, we could say 70% of our children do well, some really well, but 20% struggle in and out of significant disadvantage and life issues, and 10% do as badly, if not worse, than probably any other Western world counterpart. That 70-20-10 breakdown is a good snapshot of how our children are doing nationwide across just about all the domains that we measure. The United Nations has said very clearly in 2016, we are not doing as well for a significant number of our children as we could. I agree. There is a real opportunity to do better for our children. This report, released today, Foundations, Building Blocks, sets out a roadmap or a path for progress. If we were to adopt these 10 building blocks, we could be sure that the convention was properly implemented. So these recommendations are a means to an end to make progress. For instance, we need an overarching strategy. We need it to be well prepared. We need a series of senior government executives to take responsibility for it, to involve the community, to be accountable, to properly resource it, to have good data. These are things that we haven't done in the past in New Zealand, and it's shown because our progress so far has been ad hoc. It's been piecemeal here and there. We need a concerted, systematic attempt and a plan that is comprehensive and overarching that will move us forward. It's not as if these recommendations are being made in a vacuum. There is progress. For instance, the Child Poverty Reduction Bill before the House makes very clear a government commitment to reduce child poverty. There's an obligation also in that bill to develop an overarching well-being strategy for all New Zealand children. That could be a game changer. We have a child impact assessment tool that can now be used in respect of all legislation that may well directly or indirectly affect children. Doing these sorts of things now will improve outcomes for New Zealand's children. May we continue with the momentum. May we be unmistakable in our commitment to improving the position of all New Zealand children. So this month, a time to celebrate, a time to reflect. We're not the New Zealand we want to be for our children, but we could be. Implementing this report would be a good start. I look forward to real progress in the next 5 years so that when we're next examined by the United Nations Convention, we can say that the position and the well-being of our children in New Zealand, especially that most disadvantaged 10% and then 20%, has significantly improved. Nothing less will do. Tēnā koutou katoa.